to biology class. I am Ejiro Eferi. Today we shall continue our lesson on the topic regulation of the internal environment from the theme organism at work. This is the seventh part of this lesson, and in this part we shall be looking at plant hormones. By the end of today's class, you should be able to mention the different types of plant hormones, describe the role these hormones play in the growth of plants, and also state the general effect of these hormones in the bodies of plants. In our previous class, that's in the sixth part of this lesson, we were introduced to hormones, and we said the system that regulates the activities of hormones in the bodies of animals, especially in the bodies of vertebrates, is the endocrine system. We said the endocrine system consists of different glands located all over the body. These glands are called endocrine glands, and they secrete hormones. We also saw some examples of endocrine glands and the hormones they secrete. Can you mention some of them? We have the pituitary gland, which is divided into anterior and posterior. Then we have the adrenal gland, thyroid gland, and so on. All of these glands secrete different types of hormones. Can you mention some examples of hormones secreted by these glands? You have growth hormones, prolactin, luteinizing hormones, follicle stimulating hormones, and some hormones of the reproductive organs, amongst many hormones secreted by the endocrine glands. In today's lesson, we shall be looking at hormones that are present in plants. Before we proceed, let me give you a short story. A group of students in secondary school were given a holiday assignment to practice growing of seeds. And they were told to plant seeds in little containers like this, say in a plastic container, whatever kind of container they could find. They were also told to place the growing seeds inside a box, a closed box. And in that closed box, they should make different compartments with little openings at the side of each compartment in the box. These students went ahead to plant their seeds in the little tiny containers, and they placed it in the closed box, and they ended up closing the box. Their teacher also mentioned that they should create a small opening at the top of the box, and they were to observe this growing plant for 3 weeks before the holidays are over. They went ahead and did as they were told. After 3 weeks, they discovered that the growing plant had maneuvered through the compartment in the box and finally grew to the atmosphere through the little opening at the top of the box. The students were amazed. They thought the growing plant would stay within the confines of the box and not grow out of the box. They met their teacher and they asked their teacher, why did the plant grow out through the tiny opening at the top of the box? Why didn't the plant fill up the different spaces that were within the box? And the teacher explained to them that plants usually grow towards the source of light. And this growth towards the source of light is as a result of the hormones present in plants. So plants contain hormones as well as animals. Plants secrete several chemical messengers that cause specific actions to occur in their cells and in their tissues, in target organs, as we saw in the case of animals. These chemical messengers regulate metabolic processes in plants, and they also stimulate or inhibit growth in plant cells and in plant tissues. Plant hormones are similar to those hormones present in animals, but plant hormones are also called plant growth regulators or plant growth factors. All of these hormones perform various functions in the bodies of plants, but the major function, the major role of these hormones is to stimulate growth in plants. So how can we define plant hormones? Plant hormones are chemical substances secreted by plant cells that regulate growth, germination, metabolism, or any other biological activity in plants. So take note, first they stimulate growth, they control metabolism, they can also control germination of seed and any other biological process within plants. What are the similarities between plant hormones and animal hormones? Like animal hormones, plant hormones are only required in small quantities, in small amounts, to bring about their effect or desired effect in target organs. So plant hormones may be secreted at one point, say they are secreted at the tip of the stem, and they can go as far as, remember that the hormones present in animals are only required in little amounts to bring about their desired effect. It's the same with plant hormones. They are required in little amounts to cause desired effects. Plant hormones also carry out their action in some tissues and cells some distance away, that's in target organs, or they can carry out their action locally, that's within the cells that produce them. So these hormones carry out their actions locally within cells that produce them, or they can go to tissues and organs some distance away. So let's assume a particular plant hormone is produced at the tip of the stem, say the apex of the stem. It can carry out its effect at the tip of the stem where it was produced, which is locally. It can also go as far as the roots or to the leaves of the plant to carry out its effect at some distance away. Unlike we see in animals, where animals have endocrine glands that secrete hormones, plants do not have special glands that secrete these plant hormones. Plants do not have endocrine glands. Rather, each cell present in the bodies of plants are capable of producing hormones. Each plant cell has the ability to produce hormones. So the cells in the stems of plants can produce hormones. The cells in fruits, the cells in flowers, in leaves, and even in the roots can all produce hormones. It only depends on the kind of hormone that is being produced. Plant hormones, like animal hormones, are all chemical substances. They are organic chemical compounds. The composition of plant hormones are far different from those of animals. They are quite different from the animal hormones. What are the different types of plant hormones? We have various types of plant hormones. They've been classified into five groups or into five classes. So we have the auxins, gibberellins, cytokinins, etin, abscisic acid. We're going to take these hormones one at a time. So let's look at the first group, auxins. Auxins are a group of hormones that promote growth and development in plants. Take note, auxins promote growth and development in plants. Where are auxins produced in the bodies of plants? Remember, we said all plant cells are capable of producing hormones. But like I said earlier, it depends on the hormone that is being produced. So auxin can be produced in all plant cells, but it's produced especially in actively growing tissues. So auxin is produced in large amounts at the tip of shoots and the tip of roots. So we can find large amounts of auxin being produced at the tip of this root and also at the tip of the shoots, just at the apex of the shoots. It is also called the apical meristem. So we say auxins are produced at the apical meristem, which is the tip of shoots. Auxins perform different functions in plants. But before we look at these functions, I'll also mention that there are different types of auxins. Remember, auxin is a class of plant hormones. There are different types of auxins. The most common and the most important of these various types of auxin is indole-3-acetic acid, commonly abbreviated as IAA. Indole-3-acetic acid is the most common, so whenever we talk about auxin, we usually refer to IAA. Indole-3-acetic acid occurs naturally in plants. It is not synthetic. It is found naturally in plants. And this is the chemical structure of indole-3 acetic acid. Auxin was first discovered, or the effect of auxin in plants was first discovered by Charles Darwin and his son, Francis Darwin. They observed that in the cilii of a particular seed, usually when seed germinates, they grow out as a cilii. They grow as germinating seed and they develop the first set of leaves. As this seed was germinating, as it began to develop the first set of leaves, Charles Darwin noticed that when the source of light was placed at a particular direction, it was not unilateral. Now, unilateral means the light circulated all over in all directions of the plant. But when the source of light was placed in just a little direction beside the plant, like we saw in the case of the plant in the box, where the light was coming from one source, they observed that the plant stem began to bend towards the source of light. And they began to wonder, what could have caused the plant stem to bend towards the source of light? Further studies done by other scientists discovered that this bending of plant stem or plant cilii towards the source of light occurred as a result of the presence of auxin. Eventually, the hormone was named auxin because it controlled the growth movement of plants. Apart from growth, auxins perform various functions in the bodies of plants. Auxin is one of the major plant hormones that is usually considered. Some of the effects of auxins in plants include cell elongation, apical dominance, root development and the growth of roots, cell differentiation, abscission, tropism, seed and fruit development, and lastly, flowering. These and many more are the effects of auxins in plants. Remember, when we talk about auxin, in most cases, we refer to indole-3 acetic acid, which is the most common type of auxin. Let's take a look at the different effects of auxins one after the other. First, auxins promote growth of plant stems. It promotes the growth of plant stem by causing cell elongation within the stems. What you're trying to say is, within this growing cilii, this germinating seed, auxin will cause the stem to grow upwards. And it does this growth pattern through cell elongation. Remember that each plant tissue consists of different cells. So auxin causes the cells in the tissue to elongate, makes them stretch and become longer. And as the cells stretch, the plant, of course, undergoes growth or experiences growth. So auxins make cell walls to be more elastic. It makes the cell walls to be more elastic. And when the cell walls are more elastic, they easily stretch and they elongate. And as they elongate, they cause the stem to grow upwards and cause plants to grow as well. So auxins promote growth through cell elongation. Auxins also promote the differentiation of plant cells into xylem and phloem tissue.